Hallo and welcome back to a new review for Classroom of the Elite. Episode 5. Oh my gosh, we didn't really get the conclusion with the pseudo incident from last week. But oh my gosh. Sakura, the pink-haired girl, she is such a fluffball. She is seriously the most fluffy girl in this show. She is really triggering hard. You are kind of wanting to hug her, cuddle her, pet her, you know, all these kind of things. And goddammit, super cute. Obviously, she is kind of faking her persona because we got to see a bunch of pictures of her she made herself. And oh boy, she looks really different in these pictures. She's all smiley, all super beamy, 1000 watt sunshine, I don't know, it's just so lovely. And then in school she's this quiet person with the glasses on, kinda trying to hide it and being afraid of strangers. And yeah, well, I do think that she's really afraid of strangers, especially those who are staring at her. But when she's making photos, I do think, and I've seen this with a couple of people I know in real life, that they can get out of their shell when they are on their own making photos and stuff like this. And then they are more the shy person, so nothing out of the world too crazy bullshit we would often see. But yeah, and when Ayano Koji stepped in to fill out the form to get her camera repaired, it's really nice how she looked at him and was kind of blushing. And yeah, I do think she's falling for him. Obviously, because he's the main protagonist who is fucking badass. Basically, he is the version of Hachiman without the issues, and the badass version of all those badass characters who are not just giving a fuck. So yeah, that's basically it. And also, he snapped Susanne back into reality when she was spacing out, because we had the, not really a trial, but the meeting with the Class C and Class D, and the Student Council President was there as well. And Susanne, she was afraid of her brother, who is the Student Council President, so she was spacing out. And yeah, when he was kinda going to deliver the judgment, Ayano Koji was just like pinching her real hard in the sides, and he brought her back. And then she started to talk and brought Sakura in, who showed the evidence that it wasn't as one-sided of a brawl as they're making it to be. But yeah, that's the basic thing. And what I really, really like here is actually how she was sitting through it and also having her pictures shown. But yeah, it was really nice, and she was there showing the photos, and the other guys were like, whoa! I know their reaction, I know their feelings, I do feel the same, so yeah. And to be honest, I really think that this is a pretty good episode, and I'm really looking forward to what Ayano Koji is going to do, because the Sun Council President, he was going at him again at the end of the episode, trying to, not really hitting him seriously, but putting his hand against the wall real fast, and he was just like, meh, not going to hit me, bro. And yeah, the secretary, the little girl, next to the Sun Council president, she was quite surprised. I think it's either because the Sun Council president, he was acting like this, or that our protagonist dodged the hit. Maybe both, I don't know. We will get to see it, but to be honest, the tension in this show, it feels really awesome, and you know, the tension you have with a really good action show, you have it in this one. We had basically two action sequences, and they felt so much better than all these crazy, let's call them martial arts fights, who are overpowered with magic and whatnot, and being so upscaled that you're like, whoa, that's okay. But in this one, they are short, they are quick, they are tense, and that's it. So, really a nice one, really a nice one, and I'm really looking forward to see what is happening in the next episode with the protagonist, what he's going to do. So, yeah, it's a really good episode. I really like this show. It's such a great show. And please, Yen Press, license the light novels, because you want the money and we want the books. Thanks for listening, dear Yen Press, even though I know that you are not listening. And to my dear audience who watched it till the end, thanks for watching, as always. I hope I will see you guys next time as well. Till then, bye-bye.